and Claire. Now remember, Tommy says that she might be the one, so it's very important that we make a good first impression. You all know that Claire went to Bowdoin, so make sure everything you say is politically correct.
Dan, great to see you. Oh.
And you must be Claire.
Hi, it's so great to see you. Oh, Tom's told me so much.
Hi, Claire. Welcome. Oh, it's so nice to meet you. Merry Christmas. Or Chanukah, or whatever holiday you celebrate. Happy holidays. Happy Ramadan.
My parents are really excited to meet you.
Tommy boy!
Hey, Auntie Hannah. Welcome That's home. My Auntie Hannah. That's Grandma, Grandpa, little Brian. Although I guess he's not so little anymore, are you, big guy? Grandma and Grandpa are a little old-fashioned, so just be patient with them.
Bring it over here, Claire. You know, we've been waiting for the day Tom would bring home a nice girl like yourself. Or a guy. That's cool, too.
Come on, Dad. Give Claire a break. We just had a long ride. Claire, do you want anything to drink, honey?
I can grab you some of my eggnog. It's famous. Just made a fresh batch.
That sounds great, thank you.
I'll have one,
too. Hannah! Seriously? Don't you know that eggnog is a product of unethical farming produced by physically misshapen and depressed chickens?
No.
They will not be drinking any of that trash! No, no, some good clean water for my kids!
Okay, thanks, Mom.
Thank you.
Hey, Bri, what are you up to, buddy?
I'm watching Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
I like the owls, they're fine.
Damn it, Brian, they're called little people!
No, Dad, what? They're Santa's elves.
Tom, relax, I know that. We're being politically correct.
Okay, Grandma, what are you working on there? I love those colors.
I'm embroidering a pillow of our only true savior, the sweet baby Jesus. And the baby Moses, and the little homely baby L. Ron Hubbard.
That looks lovely.
Mommy, the cookies ready?
Oh yes, let me grab them.
Yeah, Mommy makes the best cookies.
Thanks, Mom. But are these gluten-free? Claire and I are doing a gluten-free thing now.
Maggie, you know they're healthy. Don't be so politically incorrect.
Last supper wasn't gluten-free.
Satan eats gluten.
Oh God, I guess I'll just throw these away.
Mom, you don't have to do that.
Alex, you fucking asshole. Take off the sweater with the humping reindeer. It's a bad day.
I am so sorry. You're totally right. It was getting warm in here anyway.
What's up, Brian? What's Santa gonna bring you this year, buddy?
Well, Mommy told me to tell you I'm not getting gifts because we don't believe in sweatshops, but I don't know what that means because I'm, like, 7.
That Charlie piece of shit won't bring him anything good anyway. The only person more out of shape than Santa is this fat ass, and he can't deliver a gift worth giving.
Well, at least Santa has a wife who can follow the goddamn directions on the goddamn Pillsbury box!
Grandpa, stop insinuating pejorative generals! Grandma, stop fat shaming Santa! I do what it
does! Great point, hon.
Yeah, no. Hey, everyone.
Claire, maybe if you got off the couch and onto the stationary bike like Dr. Thistlebug recommended, then you could give it to me for once!
Oh, Grandma!
You old bag!
Yeah, why does Rudolph have a red nose?
Are you blind? Rudolph's an alcoholic!
Come on, Grandpa, it's Rudolph.
Daddy, what's an alcoholic?
Now, Brian, don't you worry. There is nothing wrong with being an alcoholic. All alcoholics are very good people.
Your Auntie Hannah's an alcoholic. Perfectly fine.
Hey, Brian. What grade are you in?
This many.
Yes, Brian has some very nice boys in his first grade class, right, Brian?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Remember what Daddy told you about that boy, Chris, in your class? Very handsome. Brian is gay, which is really great.
Daddy, I'm not gay.
Yes, you are. Shut your mouth. We are killing this political crisis.
Yeah. Okay, Claire, what are you doing after graduation?
Well, I've been working on the Bernie campaign, so hopefully if he wins, I'll get a job there.
Ah, feel the burn. Am I right?
Yeah.
We've read so much about you Bernie enthusiasts, and we know if there are two things that you like, it's your free education and your devil's lettuce.
There's definitely more to it than that.
Hold it right there. We prepared for this. When we found out you were working on the Sanders campaign, my sister and I went down to the local Mexicali Blues to see if we could purchase some of the pot.
Mexicali Blues.
Yeah, we thought it would be a front for the marijuana industry, but they just sell, like, tie-dye clothes and incense.
I got this headband.
That's a great headband, Aunt Hannah. Dad, what are you talking about?
Oh, don't worry, Tom. We figured it out. We just have to tell Dr. Thistleberg that your grandfather was suffering from glaucoma.
And erectile dysfunction!
Dad, you like to Dr. Thistleberg? Come on, and put that away.
Tom, trust me. She's a Bernie fan. Brian, smoke this pot right now, young man.
I don't think that you should do that.
He loves it. He loves it.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Brian, you're going to smoke this pot and you're going to be polite about it. It's the politically correct thing to do.
Okay. Whoa. That's enough. Political correctness has nothing to do with pushing pot on your baby or telling him that he's gay just to show you're okay with it.
I'm not a baby.
Political correctness has nothing to do with what you guys have been talking about. It's about educating yourself about issues and thinking about them so you can figure out why something's right or wrong. And Maggie and Alex, thank you so much for welcoming me into your home, but I want to get to know your family for who they are. And Grandpa, maybe Grandma's right. Let's work out more try Viagra. But guys, being politically correct is about being a kind person, and even though you've mangled every social issue you've dealt with today, I'm sure you're still decent people.
That was beautiful, Claire.
That's why I love her.
My penis is fine!
Welcome to a holiday show for millennials, brought to you by Bowdoin Sketch Comedy. Hey, welcome. Starring the fabulous, I'm not gonna need a voice mess, I know. Alex, Justin, Tom Capone, Maggie Seymour, Harold LeBlanc, Julia Melton, Andrew Polly, Brian Thomas, and Pereira and Sanders. Oh, wow. New York City Comedy.
Up
to the front, that's also okay too. All right. Thank you. Elegance. Passion. Seduction.
Hey there, ladies. You guys are here with our new Snapchat Fresh Start program, is that right?
Oh, yes! My son Bobby just went off to Hamilton, and I thought, get myself back in the workforce.
Yes, we just watched the movie The Internship. Oh, so good. And we thought to ourselves, why not us?
And, you know, Robbie's always snipping and snapping and chatting. I thought, what's all this hubbub about? I gotta go check it out. So here we are.
That's just great. Oh. I mean, that's so sweet that you guys got these jobs to get closer to your children. Really touches me. Hey, you know what? I know that your son, he goes to Hamilton, and I saw on your application that your twins go to Colby, so we thought it'd be fun for you guys to take care of the NESCAC Snap story. You guys know what that is?
Yes, I do! When you guys did the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, so wonderful. That frozen float was a real hoot!
Oh, great. Well, I set up your phone so you get all the snaps that come into the Snap Story. I've got a Skype meeting with a robot. I'm sure you guys will do great.
Bye-bye. Okay, Lisa, you know what we're here to do. Let's get down to business.
Let's do this, Pam! If I get another drunk text from my daughter, I swear to God, when did these colleges become such cesspools? pools.
I only let my kids apply to a NESCAC for one reason, and it's because it got C pluses on College Prowler for nightlife, and now they're drinking like they go to UVM.
It is absurd. We have got to break this down from the inside. We will use the NESCAC snap story to teach our kids that it's cool to be a good kid.
If we do this right, it could change everything.
Totally could.
Totally.
Oh, I just got one. This girl at Trinity just did a body shot off her friend. That's disgusting. Who knows when that navel was last cleaned?
My friend Jennifer's daughter goes to Trinity, only wears bandage dresses. I'm like, Jennifer, are we really? Are we really?
Dressed? Oh, no.
now I got it. Now I got it. A cappella. What could be safer?
Nothing. It's like if my kid did a cappella, I would know they weren't having sex.
And, sex.
Sex is the devil's work!
It's true. Well, they're sending in, like, shitloads of this, so I'm just gonna send it all out there. And kids are very susceptible to peer pressure, so Robbie watches this enough, he too will join a cappella.
You know, you're so right, Pam. My daughters just got tattooed the more you know on their butts because they were dared to. They were dared to get a tattoo of that. So they did. Idiots! Our kids are idiots! We have to save them from themselves.
Well, now they have 20 minutes of Wesleyan a cappella to work through, so hopefully this is a step in the right direction.
Oh. Oh, well. Oh, I just got like 20 new snaps. Dick pic. Dick pic. Dick pic. Taking shots. Dick pic. Dick pic. Oh, God. So where is the humanity? These kids are monsters.
I know. College-age boys, like little cum machines. Robbie takes a Pottery Barn catalog into his room. He shuts the door, and I'm just...
Oh,
it's a secret.
Hey, ladies. How's your little NESCAC snap story going?
Oh, it is so great. They're so sweet, and college is so...
Yeah, I feel so much closer to Kelly and Kelsey, my two girls. College looks so fun.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look at this. Look, come here.
Oh.
Wesleyan has a drum circle.
Oh.
A drum circle.
Well, that's really what Snapchat's all about. All right, I'm glad you're having fun. Hey, we're going to a bar arcade hybrid tonight after work. You guys want to come?
Do they serve cosmopolitans? Because I am in.
Great and great work. All right.
Thank you. Oh my God, Pam, I just got a Snapchat of kids doing a historical reenactment of a Greek assembly. That's scholarly.
Lisa, look again. This is sweatier than your average agora. Looking state.
Oh God, you're so right. It must be some kind of sex party where they wear only sheets.
I'm getting snaps saying that the rugby team is responsible.
Oh no. Never trust a rugby player! Kelly told me that she was dating a rugby player, and you know what I did? I had her do a FaceTime exorcism with our priest.
Good for you, Lisa.
It was really scary there for a minute.
Well, I just put up 36 straight modern dance ensembles, so she should be dancing right out of his arms.
Oh, thank you. Oh, wow. The amount of dick pic snaps is just honestly absurd. It's disgusting.
You know, fuck this. They gotta know somebody's on the other side of this.
Yeah.
Let's snap them back. Let's admonish them. Come on, let's do it.
Let's
come on,
do
on
it. On. Let's do it.
Come on, get in here. Okay. Your mother would be very disappointed in you. Send.
Oh my gosh. Send! That was amazing! I feel so powerful. Let's show all these horny, pimple-faced turds just who they're sending their snaps to. Oh, it makes me so angry.
It's, as a mom, it's not that I'm angry. I'm disappointed.
So disappointed.
What would your mother say?
Mm, yes. Send. Yes.
Oh, ooh, snap me back. Oh, snap me back. Oh. Snap me back. Oh my God!
Oh! Oh no! No! Oh God, no!
That was
no.
Robbie.
That was Robbie.
Uh-huh. He said, WTF mom.
Oh God, no! No!
What does that mean?
I don't know!
Oh my God!
Oh,
oh my
no!
God.
Oh! Oh, oh, oh this is the worst day of my life!
Oh my God.
I have now seen
screaming. Is everything all right?
Sir, I'm sorry, we have to quit. I'm putting on an adult diaper and driving overnight to Hamilton College to castrate my son.
Not again.
A scent so attractive, you'll need to book a study room. For two. Your fragrance, like your reputation, will precede you. Morgan Stanley will come in his pinstriped pants. Invest in your scent and smell like the 1%. Smell like the job you want, not the job you have. With Corporate by LVM.
Yo, 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 what's up, what's up? So, the song is about, it's about the boat and hookup scene. And it's about how kissing is awesome.
Can't decide what with this hooking up thing. I just want to get to know someone, you know? I'm ready to go steady.
Idea? What about archaeology guy, has good arms, res life, that's good.
Yeah, totally, go for it. You know, I've heard really good things about him, and people have met in a lot weirder ways.
My parents met at a monster truck rally.
He's over there at the cafe. Go talk to him.
Dude, she's totally into you.
Oh, I don't know, man. We're just friends, I think. I really like her, though.
Shit, man. I'm so jealous. She has such a clutch ball.
She seems pretty smart, too.
Dude, I bet she's into some kinky shit.
Shut up, guys.
Oh, hey, Sarah.
Oh, hey, Brent. What's up?
Not much. Homework, you know? Hey, I had fun dancing doing backs last night. You got some moves.
Yeah, like this one? Yeah, thanks.
Yup. We should totally do that again sometime.
Yeah.
After this stupid exam. Oh, speaking of which, I was gonna go study in HL. Do you wanna come with?
Yeah, totally. Perfect.
Let's go.
Aha! What have we here? Young love? Just precious. They're really hitting it off, and it's making me jealous. Wouldn't it be a shame if something were to happen to this sweet and fickle romance, to this fleeting little passion?
Where do we even start?
I don't know, maybe we should like organize by culture. I mean, I really like the ancient Greek sculptures.
Oh, that's funny because I really like
Allow me to announce my purpose and my passion, which is to put an end to your romantic satisfaction. I'll have you say not what you mean, I'll plant false information, for I am the wizard of miscommunication. Now listen, boy, and listen closely. You're totally gonna fuck this up. Don't be so bold and take it slowly. Pretend you don't want to hook up.
Wait, who are you? Can she see you?
No, you schmuck, I'm a wizard. I got magic powers.
So you must know Gandalf.
Huh? Who the fuck is Gandalf? I'm giving you gold here, kid, trust me. By all means, hide your emotions and don't tell her how you feel.
You really think I shouldn't? All right. I really like your handwriting. Did you go to Catholic school?
Nope, I went to public school. Anyways, maybe we should start with the Bronze Age. Have you started the study guide yet?
No.
Oh, don't worry about it. Here, I have mine, I can quiz you.
Actually, I should go study on my own, I think.
Oh, okay. I just don't know what happened, like, seemed totally into it, and then all of a sudden you just got really distant and unfriendly.
Did you make it really clear that you liked him? Because boys can be stupid and you need to like spell it out for them.
Yeah, you should just go for it. You know, you have nothing to lose, and classes, they're done in like 6 days.
Yeah, you should invite him to a monster truck rally.
That's a really good idea. I'm gonna ask him out. Hey, Brett! Hey, Brett!
Hey, Sarah.
Yeah, I just wanted to talk to you about something. Do you have a minute to chat?
Yeah, I think so. What's up?
Okay, well, here goes. I think that I'm really, really into you.
Aha, silly girl! Listen here and listen closely. Aren't you too homely to be so forward? He clearly isn't into you. If he were, he would say. Perhaps he likes another girl. Or maybe, like, he's gay.
Who are you?
Yada, yada, yada. I'm a wizard, you chode.
Hold up. You're a wizard? Do you know Dumbledore?
Huh? No, I don't. Listen to me, lady. I'm a professional here.
Why do you want to help me anyway?
I, too, went to Bowdoin in 1961. I, too, wanted a relationship, but yet I had none. For me, there were no chicks, no Tinder, no nothing. No OTPHJs, no kissing, no loving. But soon I did realize it's all a big waste. Romance, that is. I'd rather be chaste. You're here for your studies, and for your studies you stay. There's too much to do, and no time to play.
Okay, I mean, I guess so. So I guess I'm just not gonna tell him how I feel?
No! Listen, take my word one more time. If you end up with him, you're gonna be living in Utica, New York, serving boxed mixed potatoes to your jam-filled toddlers while he yells at the TV, scratching his dick in the other room.
Okay.
Utica.
I think I'm really into unisex clothing. It just fits me better, you know?
Yup. That's cool. That's all you wanted to talk to me about?
Yeah, that's it.
All right, I'll see you around.
Okay. Damn it! Why does this always happen to me?
Stupid Brent!
I had so great right in front of me.
She could have been the one.
And then I let it just slip through my hands, like the cheese Toms always do at Super Snaps.
She had such nice hands. Slippery, but nice.
If only we had communicated better. Maybe it would have worked out.
If only that cracked out warlock guy hadn't in my head, maybe it would have worked out.
Well, there will always be that night back to the basement.
What pleasure I get from my work. In the love lives of others I meddle and lurk. I'll be there whenever you think to text back. To flirt, or to chat, or to Snapchat, text chat. Don't question my console. And don't doubt my knowledge. Don't dabble in romance. There's no love in college. I am but a spirit. I travel like mist. And I live on the inside of all of you kids.
First of all, thanks for coming in this evening. We just wanted to hear your thoughts on the new transfer student living in Quinby House, Dayton Rose.
Oh yeah, yeah, Clayton's a cool guy.
Dayton.
Yeah, okay, Dayton. He moved into the Quinby chapter in like the second day of classes and it's been a month and he hasn't really gone anywhere, so we basically can't use our chapter room.
Hi, I'm Dayton Rose. Was JV basketball captain?
Yeah, it was.
Dave, loosen up a little bit. Dayton Rose. Don't be Clayton. You are Dayton Rose.
He's nice, sure. But I also feel kind of bad. I don't think he has many friends. Also, he says he's a transfer first year. Like, what's a transfer first year? He's living in Quinby. None of it makes sense, really.
Roxanne! You don't have to put on the red light. Roxanne!
He literally documents everything that happens to him. And he makes students take photos of him doing mundane shit, like standing in line at Moulton for Korean bibimbap, or filling his water bottle at the library, or getting into a safe ride. And he puts it on his Instagram account, at drose, at Bowden, with like weird hashtags, like hashtag down with the kids, and hashtag no pain, no gain. I don't even get that last one.
Safe ride.
Hi. Take me to the crack house, please.
No, that doesn't exist anymore.
No. Meth house, then.
What? We're not in, like, Lewiston.
No, we're not. How about the heroin house? I'd like to go there.
Nobody does heroin here.
Okay. Then definitely the ganja house.
You mean red brick house?
Yeah, red brick. Take me to red brick,
please. All right.
And also, first, Safe Ride, take a picture of me, please, for my Instagram. I need a selfie.
Yeah, you got it.
Hashtag down. Get in, ladies. Hashtag down with the kids. Come on, get in and smile. We're friends.
You're going to have to lean in a little bit.
You can follow me, too, at drose6969.
All right. Looks great.
Thank you. My wife will love that one.
Well, it's hard because he just wants to fit in and have a good time. But it's been like 200 years since he's been in college, so he forgot how to drink and he plays drinking games, but then he just shouts for his wife and passes out. So we call security and they bring him to Quimby.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I know Dayton. He always steals my skateboard to go get Vitacoco from the C-store. Says it's good for his hangovers.
Oh, man. Oh, my sciatica.
Oh. Julianne. Oh, what a night.
I'm in love with Vitacoco. Yeah. I'm in love with Vitacoco. Yeah. I'm in love with Vitacoco.
Dayton, shut up.
Sorry.
How's my proctor? He doesn't like me too much, but hey. I'm hydrating.
Dayton, what did I say? Oh, did we get you again with a wig? Come on.
Kid's not even on Res Life. He's a fraud.
So he has these dance moves. I hate his dance moves. It's not unusual, you want to be loved by anyone.
How are you?
Good. It's not unusual
to see me cry. Ladies love me. It's a fact.
So, we first started hanging out with him. We asked him if he wanted a shotgun with us. And he looked really flustered, like he wasn't quite sure what we were talking about. And he goes to his room and comes back with this teeny little purple toy gun.
Alright, who's
ready to
shotgun?
Oh, thanks, Ryan.
Yeah,
right.
Did someone say shotgun?
Shotgun! I shot Clinton.
I shotgun.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, it turns out the gun was filled with glitter. So he shot me right in the retina, and I'm wearing this whole deal for a week. F*** that guy.
Alright, thanks so much for sharing your experiences. It sounds like he's assimilating into student life really well, and you guys are great friends. Now, this may come as a surprise to you, but Dayton Rose is actually Clayton Rose.
Yeah, I know.
Believe it or not, this was his idea. The guy's a genius. So, now that you know, it'd be great if you could just go along with it. He'll be living in Quimby indefinitely. It's not unusual, you want to be loved by anyone.
My able sidekick, Jasper Peridia. You're tuned into WBOR, the noise of me.
I hope you've got your seatbelts, because you'll need a strap on for this show.
Okay, so following the standard format of the show, we're going to outline who our two favorite heroes are. And Jasper's going to go first, because I am the last bite of cobbler in the dining hall.
My hero is Neil deGrasse Tyson, because he's remained true to the spirit of Carl Sagan's cosmos.
in his recent remake, The Cosmos, hosted by Neil deGrasse Tyson. And I did eat your mum's cobbler, sorry, even, mate.
Great. You always say that. I don't know what it means. My hero's Gene Simmons. Gene Simmons rocks, literally. He's a businessman, a family man, but he always has time for rocking. Jasper, do you think if Gene and Neil were listening to our radio show, they would like it?
It's possible.
Perfecto. Next on the docket is our Fast Fact Minute. Jasper, you think the listeners at home are ready for the Fast Fact Minute?
Oh, no, I am. All aboard the fact train!
Toot toot!
The seahorse is the only animal that gives birth through its asshole.
The moon is the largest known object.
The woman's vagina and anus are connected on the inside.
Hummus comes from worms.
Napoleon Bonaparte was so short because he didn't have knees.
No, fact checked on that one. It's because his mom fed him carrots as a baby.
Fact check, he didn't have knees.
Alaska's national language is Spanish.
When a Jewish baby is born, the rabbi cuts off his penis.
Pineapples are the second worst food.
You've got a 1% chance of being impregnated by a fish from swimming in the ocean.
There are more TGI Fridays than people on Earth.
Seth has a micropenis.
In response, yes, I do. But the average male penis is only 4.1 inches. Longer than mine.
Domino's pizza is 90% air.
Jasper was breastfed for 9 years.
Sarah Jessica Parker was in Lost.
Sometimes I cry before I go to sleep.
Atticus Finch had cataracts.
Wow, that was a lot of facts. Now's the part of our show where we discuss current events.
I'm currently wishing we was done with this evening's events.
Man, you a freak, J-Man. Okay, so if you haven't all heard, the human beings are going to Mars. As a human myself, I was a little offended that I wasn't selected for the voyage. I submitted an application, but somehow was rejected.
Wasn't it because you can only produce liquid stool?
Shucks, you're right. Zero gravity. Damn. So anyway, Jasper, if you had been selected for the trip, would you go and why?
No.
Why not?
If I went to space, I might never eat craisins again!
Good. Hold it up. And that's a word from our first sponsor, craisins. Craisins.
If I went to Mars, I'd have to drink my own urine. And all there is to do in space is masturbate, but because of gravity, it all goes up. Every day I get chipped in the eye, until finally I died of inverted testicles.
That is very morbid, J-Bad.
Outer space is cold and dark, like a human heart.
Wow, that reminds me. Jasper, didn't you grow up in a wax museum?
Yes, I did, Seth. And the best part about that was having unlimited candles!
And that's a word for my second sponsor, candles. Candles. You know who loves candles? My mom. Mama Beth Bifkin. Speaking of which, it's time to share what I'm thankful for, which this week is my very own Mama Beth. Born in 1960, this hot tamale raised 4 kids on her own while being promoted to the first female post-messenger position in our village. Aside from myself, Seth Bifkin, Mama Beth raised my older brother, Jeff Bifkin, my older sister, Steph Bifkin, and my younger sister, Seth Bifkin. Although Mama Bifkin didn't forcefully breastfeed me like Jasper's mom did to him, she's still considered to be a very strong woman. Jasper, any comments?
No more milk.
No more milk!
Which reminds me, hold up the milk, buddy. Here's a word from my third sponsor of the week, Mrs. Peridium's homemade milk for children of all ages. Give me some of that. I'm I'm not drinking that. That is rancid.
That's all for this week. Next week, we'll be discussing conspiracy theories.
For example, urinal cakes. Are they actually cake? I've been eating them.
What came first, the chicken or diabetes?
Thank you.
Introducing a new perfume for women. A scent that tells younger boys, I won't take this seriously either. For a girl whose Crocs smell like beer. For those days when, fuck, I don't know. Swug, for the girl who's given up.
Jungles of Georgia, the country, comes an untamed animal magnetism, irresistible primal urge, assert your dominance with fierce by Cote.
Do not use if pregnant or vegetarian. Consult a doctor to see if fierce is right for you.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Campus Update. I'm Tom Capone.
And I'm Claire DeSantis.
Mayor Bowden welcomed a new president, Clayton Rose. As a welcome gift, the college sent Clayton a lovely edible arrangement and the worst semester ever.
Earlier this semester, the college announced it would no longer be awarding the Jefferson Davis Award to the top student in constitutional law. The college has renamed it the Ray Romano Award because everybody loves Raymond.
Dining recently announced the addition of a juice bar in the pub called Jack's Juice Bar. Seems like a weird move coming from a campus trying to address its own blinding whiteness.
Eighty kids at Boston College recently contracted norovirus from eating at Chipotle. In response to the incident, the Chipotle CEO replied, "Holy guacamole!"
Shedding some positive light on the football team, it was recently revealed that the team's average GPA was higher than the Bowden average GPA, which begs the question, really?
Thank you, Claire. After delivering his annual speech about never having to transport students for drinking too much beer, Dean Tim Foster realized that he's also never had to transport students for smoking too much weed, and thus promptly initiated his Don't Get Drunk, Just Smoke Skunk campaign.
Well, as the semester comes to a close, we prepare to welcome back our students from abroad in the spring. Here to tell us about her experiences, you know her from her abroad blog, Florence, You Glad I Didn't Say Banana? It's Carly Pendleton.
Hi, hola. Ciao, bonjour.
So Carly, anybody with a Facebook knows you went abroad this semester. Can you tell us what that's been like for you?
Claire, it was transformative. I really learned so much about myself, the world, and life outside of Bowdoin, you know? I just had such an incredible experience. We take so much for granted here at Bowdoin, but abroad, I really had to fend for myself. I grew up a lot, Claire, and I really think people can tell.
People, did you have a big readership?
Yeah, you know, my Aunt Teresa, she's a poet at Providence College. She says I have a real voice. She loved my articles.
Well, you definitely sound more mature. But what is it you're most excited to bring back from abroad?
Well, you know, Claire, there's a lot of, like, national trust in Copenhagen, you know? Like, people will just leave their babies on the street when they want to go get groceries, or, like, if they just don't want to take care of it anymore. Why don't we have that kind of trust here, Claire? So I thought, you know, I'm going to donate my bike lock to the needy.
What does that mean?
Or, like, in Italy, if you drive a moped without a neck scarf on, they say you'll get a neck ache. Like, why don't we know about that here?
It's not true.
But like in England, they like just soak everything in like blood and just call everything pudding. And they have these weird words. They call French fries lorries and dogs are flats. And you know what else, Claire? If you want fish and chips, you have to get ready because chips really means mushy peas, Claire. Mushy peas.
Yeah, I don't think you nailed the English to English
translation. Okay, but like in Germany, they just drink on the streets and then you throw up in a falafel cart and that's called a festival. I love honoring culture like that. And you know what else, Tom? My boobs looked great in the female lederhosen, and it was really good to see my high school friends in the Hofbrau tent.
Yeah, I think you missed the point.
I don't know, Claire. I mean, I just really can't wait to enrich other Bowdoin students with stories about how I changed and grew and really learned to appreciate Bowdoin. I'm never gonna stop talking about this great experience.
Oh, we can tell. Carly Pendleton, everyone!
Thank you!
Well, finals are here.
Sorry. Two seniors recently announced a plan to launch a company after college, or after graduation, to provide men with state-of-the-art penis enhancement. When asked to speak about these career choices, Career Planning's Todd Herman said, "Not every career happens in a straight line. Some of them are curved up and to the left."
Progress has been made this semester in giving rightful attention to the issues of all students regardless of race, sexual identity, and class. The acceptance seems to stop, however, when discussing local residents of Brunswick, who are collectively known as townies. Somehow, acceptable terms include, "Ugh, Mai Tai was full of townies last night," and, "I want to get my senior eight, but I really don't want to fuck a townie."
We still think that's okay, I don't get it. The government department has recently been named as making the most dad jokes of any department. When asked to speak on this issue, one professor said it's a load of up dog.
What's up dog?
Fuck you, Tom. I made a guess. I'm sorry, everyone, we have a guess.
Sue the birds, ladies and gentlemen.
Water bottle has been left in Searle's 315. If it is yours, please come to my office, Searle's 118, and claim it.
Called in for more research into the symptoms of concussions after the men's frisbee team exhibited intense confusion, poor motor skills, and frequent sleeping. As it turns out, the men's frisbee team was never concussed. They were just really, really high.
The UK has collected 260,000 signatures on a petition that would ban Donald Trump from entering Great Britain. Other notable figures banned from entry include boxer Mike Tyson, rapper Tyler, the Creator, and Pat Kelly.
Majors who had the time to write out long, thoughtful responses because they're not in lab classes.
I don't know, Claire. As a humanities major, I found the article to be problematic in how synergistically it presented to what I see to be a cacophonous myriad. Students are irate, which means very, very mad for you STEM majors. About the poor textbook service they received from Chegg earlier this semester. Here to justify their poor service is Greg from Chegg, everyone.
What's up, guys? We psyched to get a head start on the summer internship game over a hashtag winter break.
Sure, but it's kind of early for that. Anyway, Greg, how do you respond to student complaints that Chegg books were more expensive than advertised and often arrived late?
Dude, delivering textbooks has no chill, man. Here, I know you get me. Doesn't it just blow when all your professors assign their midterms on the same week? No chill!
Okay, except it has no chill when you have three tests on the same day and no textbooks to study from.
Hey, it's like I always say, first 5 days after the weekend are always the hardest. Yo, don't get me an extra large triple shot latte over here. I am running on caffeine and pizza right now. Am I right, college students?
Right, but that doesn't seem to address the alarming business model of Chegg.
You know what's alarming? My GPA. Guess I'm gonna have to get a 200% on my finals.
What? You're not in college.
and neither is Michael Tucker, who we telekinetically who is a normal human being that loves Chegg on his own volition.
Wait, back up there.
Right, you guys should join our fan club. You would be great Cheggheads. Sleep is great. You guys want to go for burritos? I need a nap. I'll study tomorrow. I'm in denial of this paper. Pizza, studying, sleep.
Enough! What plans does Chegg have to improve its customer service? Tide Pods! Red from Chegg, everyone.
Perspective on the whole thing.
Thank you. Well, why, thank you. Hey, guys. I'm sorry about all the bad jokes earlier. Admissions has been getting complaints that their tour guides are too cookie cutter, so they hired me to add a little spice. Pumpkin spice latte season might be over, but Bobby's here now. Hey! All aboard the spice train! Choo-choo! Sorry, too far. Don't worry though, the rest of the tour will be super normal. So, let's get started. First off, we're gonna hit up Hawthorne Longfellow Library, or HL.
Yeah.
Just like I'm gonna hit the bong later. Gong, I meant gong, I meant Tycho.
Speaking of Tycho, what is the marijuana policy on campus?
Oh, do you want, you want us? I can tell you. I don't know. Anyway, HL is your pretty standard library. You got your books, the smell of pepperoni farts fall. Oh, that was me, sorry. And, you know, everybody wears headphones when they study now, so they won't hear you if you need a good cry or something.
Why are you crying?
What's your name again?
Selby.
Well, Selby, if that is your real name. I just watched Brokeback Mountain and I can't stop thinking about Ennis and Jack.
What a film.
Am I right?
Dad, this kid is a loser.
Pay attention.
All right, we're moving. The chapel is beautiful. You want to saw it on Instagram? You can go to the chapel. You know, here's a personal story. One time I peed on the chapel and I got caught by security. And then I went Macho Man Randy Savage on them and they were never heard from again. It was kind of dumb. Whatever.
I'm sorry. Did you just say you peed on the chapel and then beat up a security guard?
What?
Is that normal
Oh, no, no, no. I was just really trashed.
Attaboy! All your jabronis and your college asses keeping that old frat spirit alive.
Now, can we leave? This tour guide is crazy!
Now you know the one and only rule of peeing on the chapel, Shelly Bean. You do not get caught. Don't get caught.
Okay, we're nearing the end of our tour, so if you guys have any questions, feel free to ask me and I'll answer them, or I'll send you to somebody who knows the answer.
Oh, actually, what is the student to faculty ratio on campus?
Are you for real?
Molly thrives in a smaller learning environment.
Look, that is on the website. If you're gonna ask questions about real life. Don't ask questions about stuff you find on the website. Anyway, the polar bear. There's a real live dead polar bear inside, but that's kind of weird, so I showed this one instead. It's stone and it never existed. Plus, it has these brown poopy stains on its flat butt, which are kind of funny. Okay, cool, we're done. We can go back to admissions.
Oh, sorry, just one more question.
Yeah, sure, fire away, dumbass.
The nightlife on campus, could you describe it a little?
Kind of make it what you want to be, you know? For me, freshman year was a lot of college house parties and dance floor makeouts. TFMOs, you know what I mean? But now that I'm a sophomore, it's a lot more drinking alone and a lot more crying myself to sleep alone, usually after a failed masturbation attempt. So does that kind of explain it?
Yes, I think it does. Well, we should end it there.
Don't you dare judge him, Shelby, goddammit. He's clearly going through a sophomore slump. I've seen him a million times. You know, we've all been there. Your mother and I had some rough patches, too. Okay? We're not always the sensual, dynamic, erotic couple that you see. Here, have a chat with him.
Dad, don't.
Daddy's good at reasoning with people, Shelly Bean.
Please don't.
I had to win Mama Bear back 6 times, and I'm working on my 7th, so...
What?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure, little guy? You sure you're not a sophomore slump?
No. Yes. No. Yes.
Hey. It's okay. I see a lot of myself in you, tour guide. My freshman year, I was king. I had this girl, I thought she was the one. They called her the queen of stand-up variety sex. Emotionally, physically, obviously sexually. But then, sophomore year, things just kind of fizzled. You know what I mean? She started going off campus to parties with retrospectively unimpressive senior guys. And I was stuck spanking my ferret like you. But you know, life goes on. You got a wife now. That's what you need, a stable broad. She's a good woman, a handsome woman. And now, they had handies during Monday night football. You got whoopa time every Thursday and bi-monthly butt stuff. That sound like something you'd be interested in? Yeah. Get yourself a stable. Oh, got myself an idea. Shelly Bean, come meet Daddy's new friend.
No.
Shelly, come on.
No.
That should happen, but.